Is this City Hall?
Yes, indeed.
You look nice.
Didn't mean to block your path. Thank you for the compliment. I'm just getting my notices and agendas.
Understood.
Big night tonight with the swearing in. That should be exciting.
Yeah.
Looking forward to it.
I'm going to get a flight out of the time. just better. I'm just better. It's good to see you.
Good to see you.
Yeah. right to City Council meeting July the 21st, 2015. I would like to welcome everyone. Very special meeting tonight. If I could ask everyone to stand and join me, please, make a flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America.
To the Republic of which it stands, one nation, under God,
indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you very much. I'd like to go ahead and turn off your cell phone if you have your cell phone played on silent. Item 2 on the agenda is to swear in Chuck Welch, who was recently elected council member. Chuck is here tonight with his family and friends, and we have Judge Neville here to swear in. So, Chuck, if you would, to come up to the podium along with Judge Neville and invite your friends and family up there with you, Chuck, for the swearing in. His wife, Charlie.
Thank you, Judge. All right. Thank you, Mr.
as the packet, item three on the agenda is consideration for adoption of the agenda. Is any amendments or additions to the agenda? Not, I hear a motion to be approved as presented.
Second.
Motion from Lewis, second from Dunleavy. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Mr. Attorney, executive session if needed.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I'd like to request a motion to go into executive session for purpose of discussion of personnel, real estate sale or acquisition, and pending litigation.
Okay. I hear a motion that we go into recess for our executive session.
I make a motion that we go into executive session.
I have a motion, have a second. So all in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. We will try not to be gone very long, just a short few minutes.
Thank you. I'm going to make sure they're all He said it's a, yeah, it's a ripple and a little ripple.
If you will, thank you.
I'm sorry those answers didn't make sense.
I mean, really for me, because we spent a lot of time.
I'm not going to do wrong. I Yes, sir, that is correct.
We can
hired at the end of this month. He was kind enough to give us plenty of notice of the replacement for him, but we wanted to acknowledge him and that, but appreciate his service and dedication to the police department for us. He's done a fantastic job. He's going to be really missed.
Okay, well, on behalf of you, Chief, and your department, we have a proclamation here that a plaque that we would like to give Deputy Chief Cook, and let me read it, and I'll ask, he's around. He's kind of sit down in the seat where he's sitting. He said, don't y'all do nothing for me tonight. I don't want y'all to have a heart or do anything. But anyway, we're going to do this because, you know, policemen, they get to run of all jokes and they're not supported by the superior most of the time. And their department, not only the police department, but all their departments know that the city council and the board is 100% behind them. And we want to certainly recognize the departments and the leaders as much as we can. We appreciate the job y'all do for the citizens of the county and the county of the country. I'll read this and I'll ask Chief Cook to come up. It's Walter Clyde Cook, Deputy Police Chief, retired February the 21st, 2005 to July the 31st, 2015. Presented with great honor and in recognition for 10 years of loyal and dedicated service to the citizens of Cumming, Georgia, and the Cumming Police Department, with heavy hearts, we bid thee farewell. What lies ahead on the time will tell. No longer to be greeted by your smiling face, you leave us a legacy of dignity, class, and grace. You've instilled in us a sense of duty and pride. We appreciate your dedication and always being by our side. Congratulations on your retirement. We'll miss you. On behalf of the County Police Department, Chief, come on up. Casey, I understand you've got us an assistant chief, man.
Yes, sir, we do. We went through an assessment process. So give us plenty of notice, like I said, that he's going to be retiring. Went through the assessment process and had four individuals from the department apply and Sergeant Blue Bear scored the highest on that, and she will be taking his place as an officer.
You have her here tonight,
yes, Chief.
Yeah. Well, listen, Chief Cook, come on up. Chief, you come on around here. Let's get your picture here. This in here is going to be. This is the first chief of female chief we've had in the city of Cumming. We welcome Lisa. She's familiar with RDC. She knows some of the people there, and along with this job, it pays $100 a meeting, so we'll be getting additional $100 a meeting. Anyway, I got a motion and a second. All in favor, signify by saying aye. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Thank you, Christian. Old business done. On the new business, roadway lighting for a near 400 parkway. We got, whenever we took bids to build the near parkway, we didn't have the bids that include lighting and sidewalks, paved sidewalks. We have enough money that's going to be left over in the project that we can put lighting, but we won't have enough to put the sidewalk. There'll be a 10-foot section on each side, but it won't be paved. I'm sure it'll be used vigorously by a lot of the jobbers that goes through there, but the reason this is on the agenda is I thought lighting was more important than putting the sidewalks on it this time. The sidewalks be put in the next budget, maybe for the next time. My recommendation that we, Steve may know how much the lighting cost, if we was going to be able to pay for it. How much was the lighting, Steve?
It's $85,000 Georgia Power. It's an underground wiring, and there's 30 lights, about 185 foot apart. That's what their engineers said we need to keep the roadway in.
Be the same lights that we already have brand new?
No, these are like 35 foot. It's got a lot of tall when they're further apart. Just a lot of roadway. If we have put in sidewalks, we've got more busy pedestrian lighting.
Okay. What's the pleasure of the board want to put the lights up?
Make a motion to put the lights up.
I have a motion from John D. for the lighting of the Lanier Park Road. Do you have a second? Second, Prince. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, item two, this is put on the agenda is a parcel of land over the Lanier Beach South when the city built a pump station. We vacated a piece of land where a part of the sewer plant was over there in Lanier Beach South. And we put that on there because we had a request to purchase that piece of property further by the joint property owner, I believe. Scott and Barbara Purdue, are they here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I think y'all are a joint of property, is that correct?
We're looking to purchase the property. And then and the joint lot as well.
Okay. And they had sent a letter requesting this. And in checking on this, we have not been directed by the department head that the department had been declared surplus. I don't know, there may be a need for it at a future time for some reason, but the department, utility department, would need to get with the city and make a request that the property is surplus, and that hasn't been done. And a procedure, I might ask the city attorney to explain the procedure that we have to go through in the event that property is declared surplus.
Yes, Mr. Mayor and members of the council. Typically, the procedure would be that your department heads would make a recommendation to the city council that a piece of property was no longer needed for any future use, and then it's discretionary for the city council to decide. Do they feel it's surplus or they don't? So a discretionary decision for you to make. Assuming you made that decision as to a piece of property, the next step would be you would advertise your intention to declare it surplus. If there's no objection filed to that advertising of intention, then you would advertise to sell it either by sealed bid or auction. And typically on a piece of real property, it would be a sealed bid with a reserve. Is the procedure. But as you alluded to, Mr. Mayor, we haven't even gotten that recommendation from our utilities department on this particular case. So I think that's the first step.
Okay, in the event we, in January, when we traditionally get that notice problem, in the event we, department that declared it was surplus of no need to the city, would how would the joint property owners, are they traditionally notified?
Yes, sir, they would be. They would be.
Certainly the development.
Right. What would happen is that, again, the department just makes a recommendation, discretion with the council whether to accept or reject that recommendation. But if you went through the process, the adjoining landowners would be notified. I don't believe Mr. and Mrs. Party are adjoining landowners at this point in time. They may be by the time y'all look at this again on your annual basis in January, you can talk about. So that's where we are as of today.
Any questions? Anybody have any questions?
Madam.
Okay, we have a request here where the property is not declared surplus at this time, so I'd recommend to the board that the city has no property to sell at this time. I hear a motion to that effect. Motion from Ralph. Have a second.
Second.
All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. We're sorry we can't accommodate you, Mrs. Purdue, but at some point in time it may become surplus and the city has no need for it. Okay, item B on the streets is council has required at the last meeting. We had a request to advertise for bids on certain streets at the request of engineering. We have Jason McCook here tonight to present his findings and reference to receive the bids.
Thank you, Mayor, and council members. We received three roads from the city of Cumming. The first road was Marion Drive, say about 20, Fashion Drive. Got the three roads, the low bid was in the amount of $36,350.09. That was submitted by Jasper Building and Pipeline. The second bid or quote that we received was Marion Drive, Fashion Drive, Hillcrest Way. It was in the amount of $70,615.06. Again, it was just a reading of the pipeline with the low quote. And the last street was West Neville Road, you say about 20 to 10 Neville Road. Also includes Bright Neville Valley. The bid on that was in the amount of $93,943.33. Again, that was just a reading of the pipeline with the low quote.
And it's y'all recommendation to take the low bid. Sir.
Yes, sir. We would recommend taking the low bid.
Okay. I don't think, well, I know the city didn't budget for this, all this money last year when we worked on the budget. Is this calculated on per ton basis or per yard basis? This the asphalt material?
Yes, sir. The asphalt has been based on a per ton of getting the funding amount per project. And they bid on that in that month without it included in their report.
Well, in other words, if we didn't have the money, I think the total amount was what, $206,000?
Yes, sir, very well.
And if the city didn't want to do all that at one time, we could do what we had money and then take the other on it based on it, per times what the calculated out to be.
Yes, sir, I would probably still need it. We will be able to make sure they will own that price, but I'll need to get that information and make sure of that.
Okay. All right. Council, have any questions? We have requested bids on these three projects, and I would recommend to the board that accept the low bid and do what we have money to do, go as far as we can, and maybe by the time we get ready for it, we may have money to do it all. Based on per ton, per yard basis that engineer will figure out what they do. Chair, entertain a motion.
Make a motion.
A motion for John Lee to have a second. Second round. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Thank you,
Jason. Thank you, Jason. I think Jason Cook is the more than that there. Okay, we have recreation reference to Moshe. Director Cronin?
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mayor. We are winding down the summer, so we're getting ready for our fall program and fall event program. And we have solicited bids for the theme of our program, brochures and flyers. We have solicited bids on 3,000 copies of our 16-page program and brochure, and 25,000 copies of our time-code colored brochure that we sent out through the schools, letting them know that we're starting our registration. We received three bids back. American Printing of Alpharetta was low bid at $3,715. Soul Graphics of Roswell was next with $3,980. And the Graphic Edge of Cumming at $6,484.44. We are recommending that we go with American Printing, the low bid for the printing work. They have worked with us before on the printing of our brochures and flyers. They've always done an outstanding job, so that is our recommendation.
On American Printing, various prices there. Which one did you go?
Well, we went ahead and broke it down in case one printer was low bid on one of the items and not low on the other, so we could have separated them out. American Printing low bid on both the 3,000 copies of black and white brochure, which was $1,410. They were also the low bid on the tri-fold flyer, the 25,000 copies at $2,305. So we are recommending that they receive both parts of the property.
Okay. Conservation Board, we have a recommendation from the Park and Rec, reference to the brochures, one and five brochures, go to American Print.
I make a motion that we go with American.
A motion from Lewis, I have a second.
Go to bid.
Second. Right. In discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, under announcements, Aquatic Center, we have 2015 Georgia Recreation Park Association Class A State Swim League. I think this is the third year that they have chosen the Cumming Aquatic Center for the state swim meet. We're honored to host them, and we're going to be welcoming everyone at 6 o'clock on July the 31st for a three-day event at the Cumming Aquatic Center.
I realize it's this Thursday, the 23rd.
23rd, 24th, 25th, yeah, three-day event. Also, I announced that Georgia Mountain Regional Commission meeting will be hosted by the South County at 6 o'clock at the South Conference Center on July the 30th. If tickets, anybody want to get tickets, contact the South County, we'll take care of that for you. Anything else to come for this board? You're meeting with Jared? Second. All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Thank you, brother. Thank all of you.
Yeah.
Have a good night.
Congratulations on your award of whatever.
I tell you, there is a lot more. know where he is.
Now that you ask me, I can't think of it. It is a residence. It's a private residence.
Well, one day.
Is that one of the residents?
Isn't it the guy who was with?
Well, God, I'm here.
Yeah, but I don't think he's a private. A couple more pictures real quick. Yeah. You have your sunglasses on, you want your sunglasses on? Oh, yeah, Steve, yeah.
You didn't know we were professional here.
No, that's right.
And then Renee and Charlie, y'all want to come up here and let me get a couple of here?
Sure.
Yeah, I'm over here.
So you're the first one.
Hold. Hold. There you go.
There you go.
So it's on. Ready. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And one this way. 1, 2, 3. 4 more. All right. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Oh, wait.
Oh, he wants some too. Get out of your way.
Okay.
All right. I hope they're all that smooth.